Welcome back, Maine with My Hectic Life Pets, where we talk about all things pet and pet related. And today, we're diving into the nitrogen cycle. Now, a lot of people don't realize that fish keeping is actually not as simple as just throwing some water and fish into a tank and throwing a filter on it and calling it done. There's a whole process that actually starts taking place once you have set up your aquarium. So first, I want to get into the nitrogen cycle. When you hear the term cycling your aquarium, this is pretty much what they're talking about. You want to set up your aquarium for success, you need to cycle the tank first. Now, cycling an aquarium typically tends to take about 4 to 8 weeks. This is a process of trying to culture good bacteria within the aquarium to kind of get things started so that as you're adding fish, there won't be a huge ammonia spike in the tank that can wipe out all your fish. So what is happening is the nitrogen cycle is taking place in the fish tank. So when you first start your tank, you don't necessarily want to go ahead and just throw a bunch of fish in there. Now, some people will cycle their aquarium with fish in there, and some people choose to cycle fishless. Now, I know a lot of you out there are super excited to just throw a bunch of fish in there and watch them go, but hold off because you want to really set yourself up for success. You don't want to have to experience a large fish loss, and sometimes that can cost a lot of money, a lot of time, and a lot of effort, and it can just be a vicious cycle. So what is the nitrogen cycle? Basically, what the nitrogen cycle is when there is fish waste or fish food introduced into the aquarium, then this starts to create ammonia in the fish tank. Now, you want your ammonia levels to pretty much be at zero. Ammonia is extremely toxic to fish, so you really don't want any ammonia in your aquarium. So what happens is a bacteria is introduced into the aquarium that feeds on that ammonia, turning that ammonia into nitrites. Now, nitrites is a little less toxic to fish, but it is still pretty toxic. So what we have here is then we have a secondary bacteria that consumes the nitrites and turns it into nitrates. Now, fish can tolerate nitrates pretty well in the aquarium. And this is where our water changes come into play. So what you're really doing when you're doing your water changes or gravel vacuuming is you're trying to remove any excess fish waste that might be gathered at the bottom, creating more ammonia, and you are trying to pull out the nitrates to keep the nitrates at a safe level for your fish. Now, other things can also be added to your aquarium, such as live plants. Live plants will feed off of the nitrates that are in the aquarium, which can help keep your tank cleaner longer, and it can also help prevent things like algae buildup in your aquarium. So basically what you're trying to do when you are cycling the aquarium is get a good buildup of that healthy bacteria that will help control your ammonia and nitrites in your aquarium. So even after your tank is cycled and you start adding fish, you don't want to add too many fish to your aquarium at a time. You want to add just a few fish at a time, depending on how large of an aquarium you have. Obviously, the bigger the aquarium, the more diluted that the ammonia will be in the tank and the larger area that is covered for bacteria buildup. So you want to keep this in mind when you are adding fish to your tank. Adding just a few fish to your aquarium at a time can really, really help prevent getting any kind of ammonia spikes and making sure that you have enough bacteria that they can keep up with the ammonia that is produced by all the fish. Now, cycling the aquarium can take so long, 4 to 8 weeks. That's a really long time to go without adding any fish. Now, you can cycle the tank with fish. If you do choose to cycle your tank with a fish in it, then you want to choose a very hardy species of fish, one that can tolerate really poor water conditions very well. Otherwise, you are setting yourself up for failure, and nobody wants to just experience a ton of fish loss. So I don't necessarily recommend cycling your tank with a fish in it, but if you do choose to cycle your tank with a fish in it, please try to choose a hardier species. There are a lot of fish out there that are extremely sensitive to the slightest change in water parameters. So you really want to watch out for that and see what type of fish you're getting if you choose to do that method. Now, 4 to 8 weeks is a really long time. So is there a way that you can speed up? Is there a way you can kind of speed up the nitrogen cycle and cycle your tank a little bit faster? So what you can do when you first get a fish tank is you can add beneficial bacteria directly into the tank. Many fish stores carry bottles of beneficial bacteria. If you decide to add beneficial bacteria into the aquarium, most of those bottles, you want to make sure that you shake them up really, really well before adding the bacteria into the tank, as the bacteria tends to, in a lot of these types of bottles, they tend to settle towards the bottom. So that's just something you want to be aware of. Now, if you do have already cycled aquariums, another thing that you can do is take filter media from that aquarium that is cycled and add it to your new tank. This will help introduce beneficial bacteria into the tank a little bit faster to try to kind of speed up the cycling process. Another thing you can do is take gravel from a cycled tank and add that to your new tank. You can also take live plants from cycled tanks and introduce those into your new aquarium, because all of these things will have beneficial bacteria adhered to them that you can be adding into your aquarium to kind of get the cycling process jump started a little bit faster. Now, other things that people will do is if they already have cycled aquariums, they will keep extra sponge filters in that aquarium so they can take that filter that already has a good buildup of beneficial bacteria and add that into their new aquarium. So these are kind of ways that you can kind of cheat a little bit and get that nitrogen cycle really, really jump started and really going, so that you're not having to wait quite as long for the tank to go through the whole cycling process. Now, what are the signs when the tank is done cycling? Well, this is where water testing comes into play. There are a lot of stores out there that will do free water testing that you can take your water in weekly and kind of see where your parameters are at. These stores tend to do this with a strip test, but there are more elaborate testing kits that you can purchase to sort of test and see where your water levels are at as often as you want to. So what are we looking for when we are testing our water to see if the tank has finished cycling? So your telltale signs is you're gonna have like zero ammonia, zero nitrites, and possibly a huge nitrate spike. Once you see this nitrate spike, then you want to do, of course, a water change to pull out some of those nitrates, and your tank should be just about ready to go. Now, if you do have live plants in your tank, then you probably won't experience as big of a nitrate spike as you would if you don't have any live plants in your fish tank. Now, when we are cycling our tank, how are we introducing ammonia into the tank if we don't have fish in the tank? Now, some people will add straight ammonia into the tank, just a few drops a day, to kind of help kickstart the nitrogen cycle that way. And my method, and what a lot of fish keepers will do, is just pretend like you're feeding your fish. Add a few pellets or flakes to your tank every day as if you did already have fish in there. And this will help produce ammonia, which will help to feed the bacteria. So if you have any tips or tricks on how to speed up the nitrogen cycle in a fish tank, please feel free to post those in the comment section below. And of course, if you have any questions, feel free to post those as well. I have been getting a little bit behind on my comment section because I've just been starting to get overwhelmed with questions and comments, so I'm sorry, please bear with me. So I do want to apologize though. I have been getting kind of overwhelmed with a lot of comments and questions, so I'm trying to keep up with those as best as I can, but sometimes I'm not able to respond as quickly as I would like. I would like to be able to respond to questions as soon as they are posted, but unfortunately at this point that is kind of unrealistic. But I do still check my comment section every single day, so of course feel free to put any questions in the comment section below. And so that's all for today's video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you never miss a video. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.